Lesson 17, The Speed of Light. In this lesson, we will study the Michelson experiment, which was one of the experiments used to determine the speed of light. We currently know the speed of light is 299,792,458 meters per second, but we will use the rounded value, c, c stands for the speed of light, equals 3 times 10 to the 8 meters per second. There have been several experiments that have confirmed this value. One of the earlier successful experiments was the Michelson experiment in 1924. Michelson performed the experiment from the top of two mountains. One was Mount San Antonio, the highest peak in the San Gabriel Mountains, which is Los Angeles, and Mount Wilson, which is 27 kilometers west of downtown Las Vegas in Clark County, Nevada. These two mountains are 35 kilometers apart. He set up a curved mirror on the top of Mount San Antonio and a rotating N-sided mirror on the top of Mount Wilson. When we say N-sided, we refer to the number of sides for N . For example, in this picture we have a hexagon, which means N equals 6, when we have a 6-sided rotating mirror. An observer, or a detector, was placed above the rotating N-sided mirror. Light was shone from the bottom of the mirror, where it reflected off a face, traveled all the way to the curved mirror on Mount San Antonio, reflected back, hit the face again as it rotated, and reflected into the detector where it was seen. This only happened if the frequency of the rotating N-sided mirror was perfectly aligned with the speed of light. Light is shone on the surface of the rotating N-sided mirror, rotating with the frequency F. Light bounces off this face and travels all 35 kilometers to Mount San Antonio, where it reflects off the curved mirror and bounces back. If it travels back with the frequency not right, it won't hit the face. It will just hit some other point, and it won't be seen by the detector. But if the frequency is just right, as it reaches the rotating mirror, it will hit the same face it bounced off on the way out, and bounce again, and hit into the detector, where it will be observed. The minimum rotational frequency needed for detection happens when the mirror rotates one of its N sides before the light returns. So we'll call this side A. As the light travels out to Mount San Antonio, the mirror travels one side over, and as it comes back, it should hit the exact same side it hit on the out, but one rotation up. This is 1 over n of the mirror's total rotation. So the time for the light to travel all the way to Mount San Antonio and back is equal to the total period of the mirror's rotation divided by the number of sides. And since period equals 1 over frequency, the time the light takes to travel to Mount San Antonio and back is equal to 1 over n times the frequency. Since this is a return trip, the distance that the light must travel to get back is twice the distance between the mountains. It travels all the way to Mount San Antonio and then back again. This is distance traveled by the light is equal to 2 times the distance between the mountains. This means the speed of light can be calculated. The time the light takes to travel is 1 over nf. The distance the light travels is 2 times d. Since velocity is equal to distance over time, this is equal to 2d over 1 over nf. Velocity is the speed of light, so c equals 2d nf, and I reorganize it so it's easier to remember as 2ndf, or c equals second f. This should be memorized so you can quickly calculate the speed of light in any Michelson experiment question. Here's a quick example showing how this formula can be used in a question. The speed of light is measured to be 2.87 times 10 to the 8 meters per second. When using a 10-sided rotating mirror. So we have n equal to 10 in this case, rotating at a frequency equals to 300 hertz. What is the distance between mountains? So we use c equals 2ndf, or second f, and rearrange this for d. D equals c over 2nf, which is 2.87 times 10 to the 8 divided by 2 times 10 times 300 hertz. This gives us a distance between mountains equal to 4.78 times 10 to the 4 meters.